morning and welcome to the 55th commencement ceremony for Lane Community College. I'm Margaret Hamilton, president of Lane Community College, and I'll be serving as your host for today's virtual ceremony. We start our ceremony with the acknowledgement that this college rests on traditional homeland of the Kalapuya people. The Kalapuya were stewards of this land for over 14,000 years before the traditional way of life was forever disrupted and destroyed. As we celebrate the accomplishments of our graduates, let us also acknowledge our responsibility as an academic institution to study, to teach, and to learn from all of the effects of structural racism and white privilege on Black Americans, on our Indigenous peoples, and all people of color. It is my pleasure to introduce Amalia Cooper, who will now sing the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
thank you so much, Amalia. That was absolutely beautiful. Today, we're joined by guests who are here to help celebrate your successes, graduates. Let me introduce them to you. We have Ava Everett, our Associated Students of Lane Community College Student Body President. We have Dr. Paul Jarrell, Provost and Executive Vice President for Academic and Student Affairs. Dr. Mindy Du, Associate Vice President for Student Affairs. Mike Eister, our board chair, Dr. Patty Scott, our distinguished alum and keynote speaker, our Board of Education, who I'll be introducing in a few minutes, and our faculty representative, Lori Tapahanzo, who will give greetings from the faculty today. Thank you all for being here and participating in this ceremony. Graduates, friends, and family, good morning. Buenos dias. Zhao Xiang Hao, bonjour. Xin Zhao, konnichiwa. On behalf of all of the students, faculty, staff, administration, and board at Lane Community College, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the 55th Annual Commencement Ceremony. This is a time when we celebrate the remarkable achievement of all of our students. Graduates, you never cease to amaze me with your persistence, your dedication, your intellect, and your courage to overcome challenges. And no one ever thought your last challenge would be to finish spring term at LCC during a pandemic. We're honored to have worked with you, and we're grateful that you chose Lane Community College. So today is a day where we honor all who served. We honor our veterans, our active duty personnel who are with us today, and we welcome family and friends who supported you throughout your education. Family, friends, thank you for sharing your students with us. I'm also grateful to our dedicated and talented faculty and staff. You remained focused on our students. Faculty and staff, thank you for keeping student learning at the heart of what you do at Lane. But today, we're here to celebrate our graduates. They've worked long, they've worked hard to get where they are, and they deserve to feel pride and joy for their achievements. So at this time, I'd like to acknowledge our elected members of the Board of Education. These board members give freely of their time every month at board meetings and every day as they work closely with staff to ensure that Lane Community College transforms lives through learning. With us today are Melanie Munzer, representing Zone 1, Angela Van Krause representing Zone 2, Mike Eister representing Zone 3, Mike Keating representing Zone 4, Chelsea Jennings representing Zone 5, Rosie Pryor, and Lisa Fragola serving as at-large members. Please join me in welcoming our board chair, Mike Eister, to give greetings from our board.
On behalf of the LCC Board of Education, welcome and congratulations, graduates. We are so pleased to be able to spend this special day with you, albeit virtually. We all know that there are watershed years in history. These are years where there are profound changes in society. You will always remember the year 2020, not just because it's the year you graduated, but it's one of those watershed years. As we recover from the devastating effects of COVID, and as the horror of institutional racism comes into focus yet again, it is clear that every one of us faces profound challenge as we work to create what will become our new future. Your understanding of the world, your contributions, your energy and knowledge, your skills and your spirit will contribute to creating that future. We so look forward to your future as you create the future for all of us. Once again, welcome and congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Mike, for those inspiring words. Faculty, staff, friends, family, it is now my honor to introduce our graduates to you. There's over 970 of our graduates today, totaling 1,740 degrees and certificates. 53% of you completed your associate's degree to transfer to a university. 47% of you are earned a degree to go on to a career in technical career. 50 of you are veterans today. We thank you for your service. 106 of you will be entering the profession of nursing. 25 of you will be working as physical therapy assistants, and 39 of you will be entering the dental profession. 16 of you will be working as diesel mechanics and vehicle technicians. 17 of you will be entering the trades and construction and in the electrical trades. And 44 of you have earned credentials to work in the IT industry. 38 of you will work in culinary and hospitality, and 24 of you are all ready to go work in early childhood education. Your path was not easy though. You worked 1, 2, 3 jobs, and you struggled to find funding. 52% of y'all received a Pell Grant, and 16% received an Oregon Promise Grant. 5% of you received veterans benefits. 52% of you were the very first in your family to go to college. Well done. You have a great age span, over 50 years, as a matter of fact. The youngest of you is 17 today, and the oldest of you is 68. And you've worked very hard academically. 9% of you achieved a perfect 4.0 GPA, and 35% achieved 3.5 to 3.99 GPA. You came to us from all over Oregon and all over these United States. You came as far away as Georgia, Louisiana, Texas, and even Hawaii. And others of you came from over 15 countries across the globe, as far away as Australia. Now, one of you served as our student body government president this past academic year. So at this time, we're going to hear from our outgoing student body president, Ava Everett. Ava's our outgoing and openly trans LCC student body president. She graduates today with 3 associate degrees that culminate her studies at Lane in biochemistry, pre-medicine, and general studies. Ava started at Lane in 2018, after 10 years experience in the workforce. Once at LCC, Ava was an active student leader and held numerous positions, including staff director for the Associated Students of Lane Community College Student Government, and later on as its president, a board member for Oregon Students Equal Rights Alliance, and as a proud member of the Asian Pacific Islander Student Union and the Gender and Sexuality Alliance. Ava also served as Lane Student Advocate and as a member of the Board of Directors for the Oregon Student Association. Ava plans to pursue her interests in biomedical engineering and organ transplant theory and continue her education to earn a PhD and a doctorate of medicine. Please welcome our student body president, Ava Everett.
Thank you, Margaret Hamilton. Board of Education, faculty, staff, family of choice and blood relatives, but mostly, thank you, class of 2020. I'm Ava Everett, pronouns she, her, and I had the highest honor of being your student body president this year. And let me say, as your president, y'all were awesome. Many of you have become integral parts of this college, this community, and you've done amazing things. I'm only here because of you, holding each other up, working together, and through some of the darkest times, I leaned on you, and many of you have turned to me when something took the wind out of your sails. Today, we gather in circumstances that none of us expected, distance, but connected. The fact that you're here is a testament to your strength and your commitment. You've shown throughout everything that has happened this year. Class of 2020, it's okay to feel confused, depressed, anxious. And many of us have had sleepless nights wondering what is this world that we're stepping into? Where are we standing right now? You are forging a path that none have trodden before us. And I mean, an unprecedented pandemic, societal unrest that's grappled with racial equity injustices. It's important that we acknowledge all of the experiences of us as humans. As your openly trans student body president, firsthand, I know that so many of you experience systemic issues of being LGBTQ, POC, or because of any part of your identities. Just being who you are caused you issues in this world. And we have overcome so many of those obstacles to stand here today. Understand, in this time that we find ourselves, I felt sad. I've been angry, heartbroken, and that's okay. I know that many of you, my classmates, have felt that too. We're not alone in our grief, in our anger, in just being overwhelmed in the state of things. But in spite of all of that, know that at the end of today, we're graduates. We made it. Stepping forward in spite of everything that has happened, holding our heads high with our nose to the grindstone and taking one more step. After all of the challenges we face and that we've come against, we step forward. But where do we go from here? We come together, mostly figuratively, you understand, with the face masks and the social distancing. But all of us, together, we're going to be the ones to build this next world, to build a different world. You'll be the leaders, the nurses, the teachers. You'll be the people that move forward the tempo and tell the world what is most important. And it's okay to not know what we're getting ourselves into. With the rough job market, if we're continuing education, being scared is understandable. Here's the thing. You can't let fear just grip you and hold you in place. During this time, you may be compelled to post things onto Facebook, to Instagram, and social media. And that's important, but challenge yourself. You're able. I know that you can do it. Recognize your privilege. Challenge your perceptions. If you want to change the societal context you live in, do work, attend the riots, call up privilege when you see it, help educate those around you, and most importantly, educate yourself. Our parents, our loved ones, our friends, our teachers, and all of those who have cheered us along this long journey and extended us a hand to make it so that we can get where we are. We build this world for everything that they have given us. But let me digress. I am sincerely wowed, proud of all of you. And students, you will continue to trudge forward. We are first generation students, low income students, non-traditional students. Students, let me say, graduates. Graduates of 2020, you've been amazing. defied the odds. Take today to be proud of yourselves. You've made it. Be compassionate. Be brave. Be bold. Be you. Thank you all very much. And congratulations to the graduates of 2020.
Thank you, Ava, for that very uplifting message. And thank you so much for your leadership this year. Our next speaker, Lori Tapahanzo, will share the faculty's message to our graduates. Lori Tapahanzo is currently the Native American Student Program Coordinator at Lane Community College and a full-time faculty member. She manages the development and implementation of all programming specifically geared towards our Native American students at the college. In her position, Lori teaches Native American leadership courses and produces a summer youth college readiness program for Native American high school students in Lane County. She's also the steward of our Longhouse. Lori comes to Lane with a strong background in administration and as a faculty member at several tribal colleges and university, including Dene College, Southwestern Indiana, Indian Polytechnic Institute, and Haskell Indian Nations University. Outside of Lane, Lori is a public relations specialist, a consultant, a storyteller, a jeweler, and even an actor. She's a mother of two beautiful children, Jamiza Ba and Brianna Nesba, and is married to James Snyder, who's pursuing his PhD in education at the University of Oregon. Welcome, Lori.
Hi. Yeah. Hello. She'e Lori Tapahanzo Yenishia, Todok Uja Nishle, Ashihi Beshachin, Todok Eatni Deshache, Nakaidina and Deshanava, Natanides Denasha. That is how I'm known as a Navajo woman. My pronouns are she, her, and hers. I'm also blessed to be raised by the Eagle Clan of the Acoma people. As President Hamilton said, I'm the Native American Student Program Coordinator, full-time faculty, and also the Longhouse Steward at Lane, all the jobs that I cherish so much. First and foremost, thank you, President Hamilton, for acknowledging the Kalapuya and the traditional homelands that Lane is situated upon. It's an important act of respect to acknowledge the original caretakers of the land that you walk upon, wherever your life's travels take you. And now, congratulations to all of our amazing Lane Titan graduates. Thank you for allowing me a few moments to share some words and thoughts on behalf of my faculty colleagues at Lane. I promise to keep my remarks short and sweet, just like me. Lane graduates, we are so proud of you. We are proud of your tireless hours and your dedicated commitment to your academic journey. In fact, the fact that you're here right now at this milestone means that you're successful. I want you to think about that for a moment, that incredible feeling of success. We all know it. It's a wonderful feeling that you get when you realize you got a shocking A on that hardest test of the term, or that feeling of being on top of the world when you hand in that last paper of the last class of your last term at Lane. You know that feeling well, success. I want you to remember that feeling. Take that feeling with you as you embark on the next step in your life's journey. Let that feeling propel you to take risks and reach beyond what you thought you're capable of, knowing that success is right on the other side waiting. There are a few things that are certain in life. One is that there's no guarantees. And two is that there actually are no boundaries. We are only limited by what we're capable of imagining. So when you struggle with the inevitable thought of what's next, let today's feeling of success motivate you to try one more time. I promise you, each and every one of you, you won't be sorry. So good luck, best wishes, and get out there and make something amazing with all the skills and all the triumphs that you've accomplished so far. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Professor, for those very warm words from our faculty. Now, we'd like to recognize two graduates who represented Lane as part of the Oregon Community College, All Oregon Community College academic team, Maya Trader and Ethan Smallwood. The All Oregon Community College academic team is part of the All-State team that recognizes high-achieving two-year students who demonstrated excellence, leadership, and service that extend far beyond the classroom and benefit society. Congratulations to our own Maya and Ethan. Each year, we honor an LCC graduate for distinguished achievement and service. This year's recipient is Dr. Patricia Scott. Dr. Patricia Scott grew up in Walla Walla and moved to Eugene to study at Lane. She earned her bachelor's degree in sociology from the University of Oregon, her master's degree in college student personnel administration from Bowling Green University, and a doctorate in education from Oregon State University. She joined Southwestern Oregon Community College in 1993 to become the college's sixth president in 2008. Dr. Scott is one of only two college presidents in the nation to serve on the National College Athletic Association. And in 2019, she was named Community College Administrator of the Year by the Oregon Community College Association. And Dr. Scott started her career right here at Lane Community College. So on behalf of Lane Community College and our Board of Ed, we would like to recognize Dr. Patricia Scott for the 2020 Distinguished Alumni Award for her continued dedication to the transformative power of education. I'm also awarding today Dr. Scott her associate's degree from Lane. Like so many students, Dr. Scott transferred before actually completing her last classes. Well, we transferred them back. So now we are very proud to call Dr. Scott our alum. Let's hear from Dr. Scott now.
Greetings, Lane Community College 2020 graduates, family, and friends. Congratulations, you made it to the finish line. It is an honor and a pleasure to be speaking with you today as this year's distinguished alum. I'm truly sorry I can't be there, or that all of us can't be there together to celebrate. I loved my 2 years at Lane, and I'm really thrilled to share some of those experiences with you today. And graduates, you've already accomplished more than me because you're graduating now, not 38 years after you've left. So how did an average rural Oregon girl who loved 4-H and FFA, who was raised on a farm between a town of 200 and a town of 900, grow up to be a community college president? 40 years ago this fall, I made the best decision of my life by attending Lane Community College. Of course, I didn't know it at the time how transformational this experience would be for me personally and the impact it would have on me professionally. Community colleges help you figure out who you are. Lane helped me figure out who I was. I arrived at LCC in the fall of 1980, having graduated from Wallawa High School in a class of 31, with only four of us going off to college. Even though my four older brothers and sisters had already graduated from a four-year school, I still wondered, how would I do? In my family, it was expected that you would graduate from a four-year school, and I did not want to be the first one to not live up to this expectation. Luckily at Lane, I found my passion for school with Professor Rodney C. Metzger pushing me to set the curve in my sociology classes. I would get to school early and go to his office, and we'd talk about life, coursework, and my career path. He was the one who pushed me into doing internships early in my freshman year, which helped me find direction. I loved the small classes and getting to know my instructors. Community college was the right fit for me, just as I hope it has been the right fit for you graduates. I followed my guided pathway, which it wasn't called that then, from Lane to the University of Oregon. And luckily, at that time, you still had to read a college catalog to figure out your major requirements. And through that experience, I discovered a passion for reading catalogs and helping others figure out their academic paths. So when I got to the University of Oregon, I became a peer advisor. And this started my 36-year journey of working with students and helping them reach their goals. I realized in 2011, when Southwestern Oregon Community College turned 50, the college where I am president, that Lane was only about 16 years old when I was there as a student. And in that very short period of time, they had figured out plenty. But there was one thing that they had yet to figure out. And that is that there needed to be a barrier at the bottom of Frontage Road Because in the early 1980s, if you were running late for class, you could take Frontage Road from the top of 30th Avenue, fly down it going about 60, onto the campus road, slide into a parking spot, and run to class. Not that I ever did this. I remember my first term here. I was like most of you, an average student, an average person, with dreams and with fears, lots of fears. But I had curiosity. I had the curiosity to imagine where I would go in life and who I would become. I didn't have a clue where I'd be in 2020, but I knew I wanted a career that inspired me, a career where I could help people improve their lives. That first term, I registered late. I got what classes were left over. That meant an 8 a.m. required personal health class. And the only good thing about an 8 a.m. class was getting a good parking spot. This class was in a building that sat up tall with windows that overlooked the parking, and so you could sit there and watch students arrive into campus. So we were entertained watching students coming after us hunt for parking spots. I don't believe that the parking headaches have changed much over the last 40 years. I still experience this when I come to Lane for meetings. Even then, our nation faced a crisis. I was working at my work-study job at KLCC Radio in January 1981 when we learned that President Reagan had been shot. What an experience to be involved in at only 18. I realized that for most people older than me, they remembered Kennedy being shot, and the whole experience was crazy and surreal. People were freaking out. I realized that day that working in the media as a career was definitely not for me. And this experience does not compare at all with what you and our nation have experienced this year. You have all survived the last 3 months of the coronavirus pandemic. You have proven that you can stay focused to reach your goal. Each of you is a survivor. You adapt, you adjust to change, and you move forward. Surviving during this pandemic means you're ready for anything that might come along. Continue to be as persistent as you can and do not give up. I hope that all of you, the 2020 graduates, will bring with you many other good experiences and memories from your time at Lane. For me, another one was being inducted into Phi Theta Kappa and getting to meet the college president. Who knew that 38 years later, I would be here speaking to you graduates? I have taken all of these experiences with me and many more, and I use them every day in my work to help create inspiring opportunities for students. I want students at my college and in Oregon to have what I had at Lane, caring mentors and the encouragement to succeed. I want all of my students to be inspired to become what they imagine for themselves or what we help them imagine and to see their full potential. Please take your experiences from Lane and in life. Learn from them. Learn to fail or fail to learn. Find what inspires you, what challenges you. Use what you know to help change the world. And if I can leave you with one takeaway, it would be that it is okay to be an average person. Don't let where you came from limit who you are or who you will become. Do not let others define who you are. Remember that your experiences make you unique. They give you the power to imagine your future and define your potential. You do not need to be perfect. You have the potential within you to go out and make a difference in the world. And today you are one step further along that path. I look forward to seeing how each of you will change the world. Congratulations, class of 2020. Enjoy the journey, and thank you so much for this honor and recognition.
Thank you so much, Dr. Scott. I know your message really hit home with so many of our graduates, and I have to tell you, I couldn't be more proud to call you an alum. You make us all so proud. So at this time, this is what y'all came for. Dr. Paul Jarrell, Provost and Executive Vice President, will present the candidates for the associate degrees and certificates.
Thank you, President Hamilton. Upon the recommendation of the faculty of Lane Community College, And by the authority of the Board of Education of Lane Community College, it is with great pride and pleasure that I hereby confer the degrees of Associate of Science, Associate of Applied Science, and Associate of Arts Oregon Transfer, and award numerous certificates to these fine graduates.
Thank you, Dr. Jarrell. I'm pleased to accept those candidates who, with diligence and honor, have fulfilled these requirements for the associate degree and certificates. At this time, the presentation of the graduates will be read by Dr. Paul Jarrell and Dr. Mindy Du, Associate Vice President for Student Affairs.
All right, this is what we've all been waiting for. Dr. Du, let's recognize our graduates, the class of 2020. All right, let's get this party started. Arts and Communication Career Community. Jennifer Marianne Ng.
Honor Phillips.
Bela Estrella Rose.
Sarah A. Lopez.
Whitney Anderson.
Nakia Elizabeth Kine.
Jacob Adams.
Daniel Jeffrey Martinez.
Haley Millard.
Jashawn Clark.
Wo Lee Nguyen.
Wo Mai Nguyen.
Fletcher Herring.
Mary Frances Case.
Emily Stevenson.
Kirsten Zacharek.
Yvonne Calderon.
Tien Nguyen.
All right, now for the Business and Office Professionals Career Community. Brenda Marie Medina.
Kai C. Potter.
Anayeli Sanchez Hernandez.
Felix Ajana.
Alex Nicole Darby.
Sean Prescott.
Andrea Olson.
Christy Deem.
Lori Jackson.
Lori Jenkinson.
Jason Petorek.
Zion Claycow Stickland.
And Kylie Howland. Computer Science and Information Studies Career Community. Juan Ha.
Kaiser Slocum.
Matthew Marcellinus.
Nicolette Molitor.
Tyler Ritter.
Brian E. Thompson.
Stephen Scott.
Jason Weir.
Anthony Farrell.
Alice Zhang.
Joseph Earl Coleman.
Caitlin Ann Calloway.
Emmett Madison Crass.
Jonas Werner Woolley.
Culinary, Hospitality, and Tourism Career Community. Chi Shea.
Claudia Lassiter.
Emma Janelle DeJong.
Rebecca Glenn.
Angela Whittington.
Maeve Connors.
Kenneth Plume.
Carly Wilkie.
Alexandra Burrows.
Rachel Barnhart.
Cassidy Nicole Etherton. General Studies Transfer Degree.
Mary Menenti.
Alma Rizaji.
Zane Nichols.
Anthony Taylor Stone.
Melody Jackson.
Eric Kaiser.
Joy Suyama.
Hannah Barr.
Dwan Chamberlain.
Nong Pam.
Shannon Dempsey.
Christian Moody.
Sarah Dyball.
Young Lim Song.
Nicole Lane.
Kristen Richter.
Zar Elke.
Kaylee Noemi Aguilar.
Jessica Lillis.
Dallas Juanita Lawrence Rodriguez.
Ian Nielsen Smith.
Anne Elizabeth Ferguson.
Luis Lopez.
Jessica Anastasia.
Jessica Tao Do.
Megan Sierra Heron. All right, now for the Health, Medical, and Fitness Career Community. Karis Dungan.
Beatrice Elizabeth Aguilera.
Faith Chantel McCarthy.
Tania Josefina Nunez Hernandez.
Anika McCurry.
Vanessa Marzan Alberti.
Shelby Smith.
Leah Reyes.
Connie A. Keita.
Rosa Garcia Contreras.
Jill Rutel.
Cassandra Lynn Coates.
Daisy Ojeda.
Kirby Lynn Landau.
Holly Ann Brown.
Kendra Austin.
Allison Cook.
Angela J. Biaggi.
Sophia Hirons.
Michael Moore.
Stacy Link.
Christina Rodriguez Pena.
Katie Gallegos.
Kayla Rondo.
Rachel A. McAlpine.
Eric Dion.
Emily Ashley Barron.
Hillary Renee Pope.
Nicole Elizabeth Mauerman.
Jody Michelle McClenney.
Guadalupe Barreto.
Michael Aaron Schwentner.
Lindsay Morgan Mungpak.
Joshua Woods.
Yarmila Popovichova.
Rosario Asensio.
Christina Danielle McDermid.
Jessica Paz Gonzalez.
Madison Ann Getzfried.
Estelle L. Snyder.
Emily Jane Okerman.
Cecilia Chang.
Bonnie Fiducia.
Anne Marie Hallweiler.
John Russell. All right, Industrial Trades, Technologies, Transportation, and Apprenticeships Career Community. Troy Bendrum.
Tanner T. Trimble.
Brian C. White.
Patrick Lawana Nivelle Swafford.
Mary Danielle Shirtliff.
Jacob Reyes.
Patrice E. Mackey.
Caitlin Flynn.
Zachary Smith.
Brandy Hess.
Science, Natural Resources, Math, and Engineering Career Community. V. Wen.
Fong Nguyen.
Rachel Honhorst.
Alyssa Holston.
Sarah Milkey.
Manisha Buttar.
Clarence Beard.
Bree Feliciano George.
Danielle Christine Lube.
Zach Culp.
Julene King.
Tongnoma Ame Nakuloma.
Sheila E. Ebner.
Ava Yunlin Everett.
Social Sciences, Social Services, and Education Career Community. Anaya Gaines.
Abigail May Moore.
Dorothy Sarah Mae Fisher.
Randy Ross.
Rosa Martinez.
Jordan Holland.
Joshua Michael Hutchinson.
Ivy Law.
Just Sylvan Obonambele.
Yareli Juan Teodocio.
Serena Octerberg.
Nicholas Meyer.
Lori Llewellyn.
Macy McGuigan.
Richard Lewis.
Caitlin Silva.
Esther Padilla.
Haley Nicole Harden.
Alethea Jackson.
Kimberly Adams.
Jody L. Vineyard.
Haley Renee Rower.
Megan Ritchie.
Carmen Borland.
Ruth Becerra.
Sahali Niriam.
And now we would like to recognize the rest of our graduates that were not pictured.
Thank you, Dr. Jarrell and Dr. Du, and congratulations, class of 2020. You've worked hard, and from this point forward, you can say with pride that you're an alum of Lane Community College. And as an alum, you're going to find that your degree and your certificate is going to open doors and pave the way for a wonderful future. Members of the graduating class, in accordance with the recommendation of this faculty and by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Education and the State of Oregon, I am proud to confer upon you your degree or certificate. Graduates, you may now transfer your tassels from the right side of your cap to the left side of your cap as a symbol of your community. All your friends, family, I present to you the Lane Community College Class of 2020. We declare this proceedings to be closed. Thank you for joining us for today's celebration.